Natalie, you know I love talking about real estate. I love my home design shows. And so often you see, you know, these big budgets of people wanting to make change. But say a seller is trying to take advantage of the market and they want to put their house up, but they want to get max dollar. Or maybe they're even having a hard time selling it. Well, guess what? There's a new show for that. I know this is where Taylor Spellman comes in. You're going to be able to hear from her in just a moment. Unsold homes become red hot properties when the New York-based interior designer and home stager steps on the scene. This is the premise of this new show on Discovery Plus. It's called 1 Week to Sell. Let's roll a clip.
This is actually the living room. Tell me what you're thinking. What are your first impressions?
I'm Taylor Spellman, and I run a top interior design company in New York.
Crack these open, get the primer out. Let's just go to town.
And now joining us from New York, as we mentioned, the lovely Taylor Spellman. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Congrats on the new show.
Thank you. It's very, very exciting, I have to say. It's been a great week.
Well, it is a really great show. I was able to catch it on a little sneak preview on HGTV. Now the attention is going to Discovery Plus, and there are a lot of design shows out there. I was able to see why yours is different. Explain to our viewers, in case they didn't see that yet and want to know more, how is your approach to staging and getting a home ready to sell? How does it work and why is it different?
Yeah, so I felt like the old guard was doing staging in a way that I didn't agree with. The philosophy has sort of been, you know, make it kind of neutral so that everybody likes it. And it's, you know, a beige couch and a cream throw pillow and, you know, a modern art black and white piece. And I felt like that's not the way it should be done. We should be going in there and thinking about, you know, who is this demographic and designing it just for that person in mind. You know, is it going to be a bachelor? Is it going to be a young family? Is it going to be a couple who's looking to retire? And in doing that design, it really speaks to the potential buyer and closes the sale quicker.
I want to get your thoughts on today's real estate climate. And obviously, you guys even shot this, your team did, in the middle of this pandemic. How does that change, you know, what buyers are looking for, what sellers are looking to do? I mean, it's got to have an effect on what we want out of homes, everyone's changing their space.
Exactly. And to your point, you know, now more than ever, people are having a different relationship with their home.
Yeah.
They're looking at things that they maybe didn't look at before. They're having an experience with, oh, this is now my office. And before it was just my dank basement. And everyone's kind of reimagining things. And that's why I love this show, because it offers so many great ideas that you can do at your home, no matter if you're selling your house or if you're just in your home. There's so many really cost-effective ideas. And I always feel like it's not that hard to completely renovate something for $100,000. It is hard to do it for less than $10,000. And I'm proud of that in this show. We really give viewers fun, user-friendly ideas that I think are really realistic.
Literally, my next question was going to be all of that, because you do. That's what I think is so attainable. The fact that you're working with these smaller budgets, but then in return, it does make your job a little more difficult.
Yes.
Because you have to think outside of the box.
That is an understatement. There have been a couple times where I've walked in and thought, is this even going to be possible? But I suppose that's largely the point. You know, you just have to think a bit and think outside the box, as you said. And usually I can come up with some pretty good ideas.
Yes, you do. So Taylor, I want to get your thought. One of my best memes that I've seen recently that really just kind of blew my mind. My son likes to watch other people playing video games on YouTube. And you go, why do kids want to watch that? Here we are as adults. We're fascinated. There can't be enough of these shows of watching other people decorate other homes. What do you think it is about, even if we're not even looking to sell our own home, that we love shows like yours? Can you explain that?
Well, first of all, our show is very funny. So that's another element that I love to throw in. It's a really light watch. And if you want to just like check out from life and have a laugh and enjoy just light entertainment, this is the show for you. And then on top of it, if you like to watch home renovations, this is absolutely amazing, because we really do these massive turnarounds. So I feel like the viewer interest is based on, you know, is she actually going to be able to pull this off? Number one. And then number two, the reveal. You know, we all stay tuned for the reveal. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I want to see that before and after shot. And I want to see it have a big punch and a big impact. And this show really, really does that.
And Taylor, unfortunately, we are out of time. I do, though, want to point out your staff, the team behind you in the 12 episodes that are out right now. You really get a close-knit group that you've got there, right?
Yeah, it's so fun because that's my real team in New York. And when we came on to do the show, it just felt really natural and really organic. And I think you'll be able to see that.
One Week to Sell, streaming now on Discovery Plus. Now we need your team here in Tampa and in Florida.
We'll give you my address.
Good to see you.